I have a really fun tag video for you, and I know the title is very suggestive, but I promise it's not about what you're thinking. This is just a really fun tag video that has been going around, and I've seen so many YouTubers do it, and I think it's really fun to see everyone's answers because it's definitely unique to the person. And this tag is called My First Time because it talks about or asks about different firsts that you've had, from like your first kiss to your first CD and all of those sort of things. So I'm gonna go ahead and get into the questions, and I'm sorry if I miss one or two because I could not find a video for the life of me that had a list of the questions. So I just watched a couple of them and kind of typed them up, so hopefully I got most of them. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get started, and I hope you girls enjoy this. So the first one is my first word, and I actually have this written out from my parents. My mom wrote in this book for me when I was a baby, and so there's a lot of really cute things in here, like notes from like the hospital and when they were getting ready for me and stuff. I definitely want to do one of these for my children in the future because I think it would be so cute. But I bookmarked the page, and actually it looks like once I was born they were kind of more busy with things like taking care of me than writing in this book. But you can see right here, my first word was dada, and I honestly feel like most people that have done this tag video, that's the answer, and I think that's really funny. I don't know, I guess we all just have like a fixation on our dads when we're little or something, but I definitely was a daddy's girl growing up, so yeah, that was my first word. The next one is my first friend, and with this girl, it's actually pretty much my first memory that I can think of personally, and it was in preschool. Her name is Alyssa, and I'm actually still friends with her. I graduated high school with her, and every time I'm home from school, I visit with her, and we hang out, and we have a really great time, and we get along so well. But one of my first memories with her is playing on the playground at our preschool, which actually doesn't exist anymore, so it's really weird to think about, but there was this kind of like spinning thing. Maybe it's a merry-go-round. It might be called a merry-go-round, but not like with like a carousel and stuff. It's just like a little one, and you'd get on it and you'd run and like push it and then jump on it and it would spin you around. And I don't know why, but that's one of my first memories, is playing on that with her. And I loved that thing so much, but it's really funny because now I cannot do spinning rides to save my life. They make me so sick. The next question is my first pet, and I feel like this one is also very similar to others who've done this tag. I had a fish. I honestly can't remember what I named it because I was pretty young, but then it died probably a few weeks later and I was really sad. My family kind of went through like a bunch of different fish before we kind of just gave up on the idea of it. And then when I was older, probably about 12 or 13 years old, we got our first dog, and her name is Molly. She's a golden retriever, and we still have her today. She is such a sweetheart. We actually have three dogs, so it's kind of crazy around the house sometimes, and I'm lucky to be able to film in between them barking. The next one is my first fear, and I'm not totally sure on this one, but I'm gonna go with the generic because I think it is true, and I'm gonna say my first fear was of the dark because I definitely was very focused on my nightlight. It had to be on or I could not sleep. It just was not happening. And I also think that something that kind of added to that, I don't know how many of you had Furbies growing up, but I had kind of stopped playing with mine for a while, and so it was up in my closet, just like off, and I hadn't played with it, but then it just decided to kick itself on, and it like, since the batteries were low, the voice was really low, and it sounded like really scary and demonic pretty much, and then it ended up just on like one tone, like screeching, and I was probably like, I don't know, 7 or 8 years old, and I was not happy about that. I was terrified. I still don't like Furbies. It was just really creepy. So yeah, I think my fear was definitely, my first one was definitely of the dark because it's just creepy. I still don't like being alone by myself in the dark. It's just not, I don't know, I don't like it. The next one is my first crush, and I feel like this could kind of vary depending on like if it's actually someone that I wanted to date or if it was just like a boy that I liked in elementary school, because I feel like we all kind of had those, but I guess I'll go with that one. So there was a kid, I think in kindergarten, I don't know why I had decided already when I was in kindergarten that I was gonna like a boy, but I did, and I'm pretty sure his name was Zach. I remember that he had blonde hair and that I thought he was really cool, so good times in elementary school. The next one is my first kiss, and honestly, this was like one of the most awkward experiences of my life. It really wasn't that bad, but I feel like everyone's first kiss is just kind of like a forced moment because you just want to like get it over with, and I really feel like I wasn't ready for it. So it was homecoming. I think I was 16. I was either 15 or 16, and we were slow dancing. So, I mean, it could be kind of romantic, I guess, but we were slow dancing, and I think he said something corny about like how much he liked me, and then we kissed really quick, and then I was just like, oh my god, did that really just happen? Like, why? So it was really awkward, and we probably only dated for like a week or two after that before it was just like, okay, we can just not do this anymore. I really haven't had too much dating experience in my life, and that was a really awkward moment, I'll be honest. The next one is my first celebrity crush, and I probably could talk about a lot of different people, but I'm pretty sure the first one that I seriously was in love with is Daniel Radcliffe. And he obviously plays Harry Potter in the Harry Potter series, and that started when I was really young. So I kind of just grew up with Harry Potter, and I was always in love with him for that role and just in general. So yeah. The next one is my first boyfriend, and I was one of the few people who didn't have those like awkward 1 week long relationships in middle school. It wasn't my thing. I never really asked anyone and just kind of stayed away from it. So my first boyfriend was when I was 16, and I think it was junior year of high school. Yeah, junior year of high school. And we dated for like a month. We went to homecoming together, and that was my first kiss also. So, woo! I actually really haven't been in any kind of serious relationship since then, and I'm kind of happy about it, to be honest. Nothing against boys, but they're just not my favorite thing in the world. So, yeah. The next one is my first job, and this was over the summer of 2010, I think. I was 15, and I actually stayed in Maine for the summer with my stepsister, and I worked at a bed and breakfast as a dishwasher. Definitely wasn't the most glamorous job, but it was a lot of fun. I loved the people that I worked with in the kitchen, and it was really great just to kind of get the experience of being away from home, for one, because I lived in Maine for the summer, but also to get the experience of like working and just kind of figuring myself out and everything like that. And I will always be grateful for that job, and there are still songs I hear that remind me of that summer and just make me so happy. So it was a really great experience. The next one is my first concert, and I remember this so clearly. I grew up obsessed with Evanescence, and they're kind of like a darker, like heavy rock band. So it was like the weirdest thing. Like, it really didn't fit my personality when I was growing up, but I just always loved Evanescence. Amy Lee's voice is so beautiful. I still love them. I just don't listen to them as often as I used to. But at the time that I went to their concert, I was in love with them. And we had gone on a road trip with my dad, and we were on our way home, and he kind of just randomly had stopped probably like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and usually we drove until like 8 o'clock at night when we did road trips. So I was really confused. I didn't know why we were stopping so early, and like we kind of got like a hotel room, and we were getting the room figured out and stuff at the front desk, and the lady was like, oh, you know, it's gonna be this much. And my dad was like, oh, like that's a big rate or whatever. And she was like, oh yeah, it's because of the concert tonight. And I was like, oh, the concert. And my dad got this huge smile on his face, and he looks at me, he goes, Evanescence. And literally I like dropped to the floor and started crying because I'm such a fangirl. And that was one of my favorite concerts that I've ever been to. It was epic. Amy Lee is gorgeous, and her hair flipping everywhere was just fabulous. I loved that concert. The next question is my first car, and I only had this for about 2 weeks. It just didn't work out. It's a long story. I could probably talk about that in another video, but I had a blue Honda Civic. It was a 2002, I believe, and it was standard, so it was really, really hard to drive, but I was very proud of myself for learning how to drive a manual car, and I still could do it today if I needed to, but I would struggle because it's been since I was about that old that I've driven a standard car. Since then, I've been driving automatic cars. But I don't have a car of my own right now, and I'm probably gonna have to wait until I graduate college, just because out-of-state student probs, I'm kind of too broke to buy a car, and I really don't need it because I go to school in a pretty busy area, so I can just take buses and ask my friends for rides and things like that. And the last one is my first YouTube video, and I kind of have two answers for this one, just because the first video that I ever uploaded to YouTube was not to this channel. I probably had like 3 or 4 YouTube channels before I actually made Curly Hair Love and started making videos on this channel. And so I think my very first YouTube video was probably like a really stupid music video with one of my friends that just was like a hot mess and wasn't even edited that well, just because everyone was making YouTube videos that were music videos at that point, and I just thought they were all so cool. And so did me and my friend, and so we were just like, yeah, one night we had a sleepover and we made a music video and uploaded it. And if I can find it, I'll try to link it below, but I probably can't because I can't even remember what the channel was called. My first video on this channel, I'm going to try to find so I can kind of insert it over right now, but it was a really awkward hair tutorial. I didn't even talk. I just took the audio out and put music over it and used titles to say what I was doing. And I can't even remember like what kind of hairstyle I did, to be honest. I'm gonna have to go look it up, but I know I was doing like some kind of curly hair tutorial, and I was just like, oh, like here's this hairstyle, but I'm not gonna talk because I'm awkward, yay. And also you can just see how much I've changed because I was 16 when I made that video. So I'm 19, almost 20 now, and I cannot believe that it has been that long since I've started YouTube. It absolutely blows my mind. So yeah, that was it for my first time, the whole tag video. I really hope that you girls enjoyed this and kind of learned some more things about me. I really have loved watching so many of these different videos by different YouTubers. I think it's so fun and just a cool way to learn different things about them. So yeah, if you want to, go ahead and leave me some of your answers in the comments below or leave me a video response. If you want to, that'd be really cool. I'd love to watch it. And also, I'm probably gonna tag some people in the down bar, so go ahead and check down there. But I tag everyone watching this. And yeah, I guess that's it. So don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did like it. Subscribe to me if you want to see more videos from me. And also follow me on Twitter and Instagram and all that fun stuff. They're always linked in the down bar, and I love talking to you guys on those networks. And yeah, I guess that's it. So I will see you guys in my next video. Bye! Thumbs up to my friends drinking whiskey. Peace out to the girls that